Do you want to be rich? You probably do, right? Even if you currently have a job, it may not be enough to accomplish all your dreams. You probably want to buy a house of your dreams, study in a school of your dreams, wear expensive suits, and drive an expensive car. You need more streams of income. One good way to do this is to have a side hustle. A side hustle doesn't have to be elaborate. You can run a dry cleaning outfit with a couple of washing machines, detergent, and hired labor for ironing and stretching, or do home delivery of cakes and confectionery. It all depends on you. It should, however, not clash with your current job. Side hustles can bring in a juicy profit, but only after you have done it for a while. In the meantime, your salary sponsors it. You don't want to pay too much attention to it and lose both the job and income to continue to sponsor your side hustle. In today's video, I'm going to share with you 5 best side hustles that can make you money. 1. Uber driving. This is definitely something you should look into. You may be going in a particular direction to work every day, and also while returning home, your car is always empty. It may be good to use the Uber platform to make some cool cash while driving to work or while returning. You need to consider your options though. It is a terrible idea to get stuck in traffic on your way to work because you picked up a passenger from Uber. You need to know your route very well. If the road is usually free during the morning hours, why not? It depends on you. If you're comfortable having people in your car, it can be your own side hustle. The truth is, even during the weekends, when you are not working out or hanging out with friends, you can be out driving people to places. You can do this for 4 hours on Saturday and another 4 hours on Sunday, then every morning and evening during the week. By the end of the month, you should be getting something substantial enough to almost cover your rent if you're serious. That way, you can save up your salary for investments and stuff like that. Remember to only accept driving requests to locations you are familiar with. It will help you get good reviews from the people you carry. Try to be nice and friendly. Don't make the person you are driving feel like he or she is going somewhere with a total stranger. Relax and don't appear tense. They may start thinking you are a criminal. You're going to be okay. While driving someone, try to pay attention to them if they're very familiar with the route. They may have the insights you don't have. Try to have some conversation, but keep your eyes on the road. Avoid sharp bends and sudden braking that makes them feel like they're in danger. 2. Be a freelancer on Fiverr or Upwork. Freelancing is the in thing these days. By just having a smartphone or a laptop, you can log into Fiverr or Upwork and get gigs daily. You might either be a content writer, a copy editor, a blogger, or a graphic designer. You will fit right in. You need to be consistent, though, to enjoy bigger gigs. You have to deliver on time and deliver quality work to get good reviews. Once you start, you need to ensure you have a computer that is in good working condition so you don't disappoint the clients. Don't accept any job you may not have the time to do. Instead, inform the clients or don't bid at all until you're ready. Some freelancers make up to 6 figures a year. This could be your story too. It's dependent though. It can be a full-time job. So if you start up newly and you're still working, focus on doing it during the weekend when you have the time and energy, and resist the temptation to take up gigs on weekdays when you have your job to do simply because you need more cash. Set up a great profile on Fiverr and Upwork and submit. They will respond in less than a week. Once your profile is set up, you are ready to start accepting gigs. Work very hard and earn great reviews. With time, your prices will become higher. It's a gradual process, but you will get there with enough determination. 3. Deliver food. There are a lot of fast foods that want people to deliver for them. If you don't like the idea of riding with people in your car, maybe a box of pizza may not be as scary. It's a legit side hustle you can take. You can deliver it to anyone and only take delivery orders at your convenience. That way, you only make money when you feel like, just like Uber. You want to make sure your car is neat. If not, the person you're delivering may get anxious about the food's condition. Also, make sure you leave on time. You don't want the person waiting for their pizza to starve because they are waiting for you. You can deliver for DoorDash or Uber. Try not to eat any of the customer's food. They will probably notice. Even if you are hungry and can buy it, don't eat it. This is because of the time it might take to get another one ready, the distance between where you are and where the outlet is, and how long the customer will have to wait for their order. you can bring a bad reputation for both yourself and the fast food. It's a bad idea. Don't do it. You can deliver food really fast for people. Perhaps this is why this is a great side hustle. Food goes in a particular direction. Food doesn't talk. Food doesn't suggest new confusing routes. And people who order food generally want it hot, so they don't order from distant places. It's a win-win situation, really. 4. Affiliate marketing. If you have a website, you can do affiliate marketing. People may not know about a brand that is really good for them because they can't see it. With affiliate marketing, people can place an advert on your website and you can earn a commission anytime someone clicks on it. Just make sure your business is not a scam. If someone gets scammed, he can associate the scamming company with a platform that redirected him there. Besides that, it's a pretty good business. Some blogs get over 100,000 impressions every month. Imagine how much you can make if you had ads at a minimum of 100 clicks daily at a commission of 50 cents per click. It can be up to $1,500, give or take. You need to really consider whether this isn't for you or not. Affiliate marketers usually have to have a website. This can be a little bit expensive to set up. If you don't have one already, perhaps you can explore other side hustles while you set it up. Even if you do have a website, the traffic of your website determines your eligibility. If your site doesn't have much traffic, you will not be able to do affiliate marketing. Number 5. Manage social media for business. In this pandemic period, a lot of businesses have moved online. There's a high demand now for social media managers than ever before. This means that it is a very lucrative side hustle. You can help businesses set up, handle and create content strategy and posting plan. It is something a lot of businesses need at the moment. Many business owners don't know how to get their customers to see their work on social media. They also don't know how to write engaging content that can be seen on Google when people search for related keywords. You may need to take the Google Free Digital Marketing Certification to get started. You will learn about search engine optimization, websites, Google Ads, social media, how to choose domain names, and which platforms a business should set up first. It is a pretty detailed class with a lot of examples that make it easy to follow. You should really consider taking it. You can also read up content on HubSpot about social media management. They are very detailed and have lots of free ebooks and are insightful. You can check out their Instagram for business and Twitter for business. The strategies are different. If it's a new brand, consider the cost of promotion to increase the brand's visibility.